Hi, I'm Kevin Passaro, founder of Oberwerk Binoculars. You probably noticed when you landed on our website that it says right across the top, world's leading supplier of high-power binoculars. You thought, what does that mean? Well, when we say high power, we mean any binocular capable of 40x magnification or higher. And we've been in business for almost 25 years now, and I'd say over the last 20, it's true that we've sold more high-power binoculars than all the other manufacturers out there, combined, actually. And what you're looking at are high-power binoculars. These are the XL series binocular telescopes, even the smallest, capable of significantly higher than 40 times magnification. Actually, this one can go to 56 times magnification. All right, so the XL series, we call them binocular telescopes because they use telescope focusers that hold interchangeable eyepieces. And in a binocular telescope, it's the eyepiece that determines magnification. Now we have three eyepieces available. As we go larger in aperture, that changes the magnification range. So the next size up, the BT-82, can go to 64 times magnification. The midsize BT-100 can go to 80 times magnification. The next size up is the 120. And then the flagship product, the 127 down at the end. Both of these can go into the mid-90s in magnification. It's not a dramatic difference. The big difference is light gathering, which in daylight doesn't matter that much. So if you're buying one of these to look at whales or ships out at sea, really the smaller models will do just fine. If 64 times magnification is enough, the BT-82 might be just as good as the 120. If you're buying one of these to do astronomy, again, magnification is the main difference when you're looking at bright night sky objects. If you're looking at planets like Jupiter and Saturn, the moon, of course, is very bright. The large aperture, all that light gathering, isn't going to make much difference on those bright objects. So again, the main difference is going to be the top magnification. So you can get beautiful views of the planets with our smallest binocular at 56 times magnification. Now, if you're interested in viewing dimmer objects like galaxies, nebula, star clusters, things like that, well, for those objects, the more light gathering, the better. So the larger the binocular, the more detail you're going to see in those dim objects. The serious amateur astronomers are going to want much aperture as possible, either the 120 or the 127. The smaller binoculars are much easier to mount and to move around. They're much lighter weight, starting with 8.5 pounds with the 70. About 10.5 for the BT-82, just 12.5 for the 100. When you get up to these, the 120 is about 20 pounds, and the 127, close to 25 pounds. So big difference in weight once you go beyond the BT-100 binocular. That also influences what mount you can use. So the lighter binoculars can go on any type of mount. We can put them on our TR3 hardwood tripods. We can put a carbon fiber elevator in there so you can get instant height adjustment, quick and easy. Can't do that with one of these big binoculars. Can't use the carbon fiber elevator. So again, if you're buying a binocular to look at your beautiful view, one of the mid-size models might be your best bet. It's more flexible, easy to move around. Okay, well, that's it for the XL series. If you still have questions, feel free to give me a call, shoot me an email, info@oberwerk.com, or just call and phone and ask for me. My name is Kevin, and I'd be happy to talk to you. Thanks for watching.